Hello YouTube people, today I'll show you my favorite G-Shock 5600BB. Wait a second, not this one, this one. This one is still good. Yeah, let's talk about this beautiful watch. Well, as all things, this watch has positive points and negative points, but these negative points are not so strong and there aren't many of them. So let's talk first about negative points. The first negative point is pretty obvious. The first thing you notice as you start actually using this watch is these buttons. They are not comfortable, not easy to use. You can't just simply press in with your finger. You have to apply quite a lot of force, and usually you have to press these buttons with your nail to get better accuracy. Well, I understand the idea behind that. These buttons are very well protected from unwanted, bumps. You aren't gonna reset your timer just by bumping this watch into something. But I would say these buttons are a little bit over-engineered, over-protected. Just a little bit too much. For some people, it's not a big problem. Well, for me, it's just a little bit annoying, not a big deal, but they are a little bit annoying, these buttons. So I just wanted to mention that they are not very user-friendly buttons. Another negative thing is the function that I miss on this watch quite a lot. For example, I am using this countdown timer, right? And I want to set it to 5 minutes. So let's set it to 5 minutes. And oops, I went a little bit too far, and I want to go back 2 minutes, and nope, this button doesn't go back. You can only advance the numbers, you can only go forward, and yes, you can hold it in and it will keep going faster, and if you're lucky you will stop at 5 minutes as you want. For example, yeah, like that. But the problem is it doesn't go back, only goes forward. A little bit inconvenient, I would say. And another little negative point of this watch, well, it is not really noticeable right away. You're gonna notice that negative point a little bit later on by wearing this watch. The rubber band and the case aren't really coming together very, very nicely. There is always a little gap in between the rubber strap and the case. It's not a big deal at all. Well, once you notice this gap, you aren't gonna unsee it. But it's not a big deal, you know, it's just, I just wanted to mention it. About all the negatives, buttons aren't really perfect. It is missing one function. It cannot go back in numbers. And sometimes you can see the gap between a rubber strap and the case. That's it. That's all the negative points I can think of this watch. And they aren't really that big. And this watch has a lot of positive points. Let's talk about them. Well, first positive point I would like to mention is this LCD screen. Well, it is negative LCD screen. It is black, but out of all negative LCD screens with all design, this is one of the best Casio makes. It's very readable, very easy to read, even in dim light, even on extreme angles. It's not really that easy to read as, for example, F91W, but as for a negative display, this display is really good, really good. And in certain lighting situations, you can see that it has blue tint. It looks amazing. It looks so good. And speaking about this screen, there is another positive point. For example, this F91W only shows you day and date. And this G-Shock shows you day, date, and month, which is a plus. Sometimes I actually forget which month it is, and it's very nice to have it on the screen without additionally pressing any buttons. And another good thing about this screen, that it has a very good light, very good strong backlight. You press the button and it keeps shining for several seconds. Very, very good backlight. Another positive thing, this function, which I like a lot. Look, I go to countdown timer, right? I can start using countdown timer, right? And while I'm using it, I can still see the time on the top of the screen, which is so convenient. It's so good. And I can use stopwatch, and at the same time I see the current time on top of the screen, which is very convenient. I like this a lot. Not all G-Shocks have this function. Another very small thing which I like, it has two different beeping tones. Let's see, I go into menu, and when I go back to the watch, it has different kind of beep. So I, without even looking, I know that I am back to the main screen. This is very nice to have. I like it a lot. And another very, very strong positive point of this watch, that it is super comfortable on the hand. It is very, very comfortable on the hand. These rubber bands have these little hands that rest into the case of the watch, and they do this thing. I can bend the strap, and the strap bends in a way that it gets rounded up. It gets comfortable wearing on the wrist. Look. I lock it up, and because it has these parts resting into the body, it gets into this nice oval shape, which means that when I put this watch on my hand, there are no points where this watch would be pressing my wrist stronger than any other points. It presses my wrist evenly all across the surface. It feels very, very comfortable on the hand, and it's light, it doesn't wobble, it feels very stable. It is very good on the hand. It's so comfortable. You can basically forget that you have a watch on your hand. So that's a very big plus point for me. And another positive point I'm gonna give to this watch, because in my personal opinion, this is the coolest looking G-Shock. The best looking G-Shock, in my opinion, the coolest one. It doesn't have any unnecessary things, any gimmicky functions. It's just simple, clean design, clean functions, nothing unnecessary. And the design of this watch, I ain't gonna get old. Never. Because it's simple. And the final, the biggest positive point, which is basically the main idea of this watch. Why this watch was built the way it was built. It was built for purpose, for durability. And it was done very well. I mean, it is super durable, very durable. You aren't gonna kill this watch just simply throwing it into a wall. Just simply freezing it into ice, washing in washing machine, or boiling for 1 minute. Believe me, I have done those tests. I know what I'm talking about. Don't do this to your watch. I don't want to be responsible for that. I just want to say that I have done these tests to this watch, and I pushed this watch to the limits and beyond, quite literally, as you can see the end result. And you can see the compilation of these tests in the link in the description. The video quality is very bad because I have done these videos spontaneously on my mobile phone. And it was just for fun, for me, basically, but you will get the idea how strong this watch is. It's absolutely unbelievable. I've been smashing this watch into a wall. I've been testing it out with a magnet, many other stupid tests, and it was just fine, just fine. That's why I bought another one, because this watch is simply unbeatable. This very, very strong watch. So that's it. I told you all negative points I could think of, all the positive points, which are plenty. And this watch is truly awesome. Like, I do recommend it. But before buying, you should actually test it. You should test these buttons. Are you okay with these buttons being this difficult to use? Or not, you know, some people don't really care, some people feel a little bit annoyed by these buttons, but you know, you test for yourself before buying. But speaking overall, this watch is just absolutely incredible. It looks super cool, it is very, very durable, amazing, I love it, great watch. Bye bye, we'll see you in the next video. By the way, hold on, wait a second, I just did a video on my another channel with Ford Fiesta R5 on Dirt Rally 2.0, and I beat my record time. It was amazing run. So if you are into cars, you can check, the link is in the description. I hope you're gonna like it. So have a nice day. Goodbye. We'll see you in the next video.